basically copied Miami.
Just like Sam was explaining there, after the huge earthquake of 1931 that decimated the city, they rebuilt it in the style of Art Deco and copied Miami. So it was really cool.
We are arriving to Wellington, New Zealand.
Turned into gold, but the dream was too much for you to hold. Now over and over I keep going over the world we knew.
So the joke that we had going here is that I was giving everybody a walking tour of Wellington. We have Ivan and Vivienne with us, and we went to the top of the cable car to walk down through the botanical garden to the rose garden at the bottom. And also our friend Lackie joined us partway through and participated in the walking tour of Wellington that Eric was giving. Anyways, it was a lot of fun.
Each road that we took, it turned into gold. But the dream was too much for you to hold. Now over and over, I keep going over the world.
Trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself,
the botanical garden had a succulent area that Letty would have absolutely loved. There were so many cactuses in here. Halfway through the walking tour, I took them to the gift shop, so this made everybody very happy and kept the tour working along its way down the hill.
What a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more. And I never knew, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself.
That unique-looking building in the distance is Wellington's Parliament Building, nicknamed the Beehive.
Do you know
Old Bank Arcade in Wellington, New Zealand is actually neither an arcade nor a bank. It's a shopping center housed in, as the name suggests, the Old Bank of New Zealand. And the centerpiece of the center is this unique animated mechanical musical clock, which opens each hour to reveal scenes of Wellington Harbor's past and present. The Bank of New Zealand, an architectural gem in the town, opened its headquarters in 1901. It eventually fell into disuse, and when it was renovated in the 1990s, something quite unusual was found. Plimmer's Ark, a three-masted sailing vessel, was unearthed from beneath the ground floor. In 1851, an earthquake ran the ship aground, and her wreckage had lain there ever since. It had been used as a pier, an auction house, and a ship's equipment store in the later half of the 19th century, but was covered up when the bank was built on top of it. The remains of Plimmer's Ark are on display in the Old Bank Arcade today, but for a more animated approach to the history, one need only look up to the musical clock. Every hour on the hour, the timepiece unfolds to reveal tiny vignettes depicting important moments in this site's past. The clock commemorates the history of the building, the ship, and the land surrounding, encouraging shoppers to stop for a moment to think about all that has happened in the place that they stand.
And the next news site we will see will be Milford Sound on our way to Australia.
Our friend Karen explained to us that the best time to come to Milford Sound was in a rainstorm. So I went researching it and found out that this is the most densest packed place on earth to see temporary waterfalls during a rainstorm. And it's true, there was literally water coming down the cliffs everywhere. Milford Sound is a very recreational destination for people from Queenstown, New Zealand. They drive 4 hours to get to Milford Sound. There's a resort at the end of it, kayaking, all kinds of water activities to do here. So the boats that we see are actually people coming from the end of the sound out to have a look at all the waterfalls. Same as us, except we are in a huge cruise ship sailing into the sound, so it's pretty cool. And it's actually technically a fjord. It was misnamed by early explorers, and they've just stayed with that name, even though it is a fjord.